Now for the second session, we have two presenter speaker. The first one is Dr. Rohadi, MD, FICS, Fellow of the International College of Surgeons. And the second one is Dr. Muhammad Faris, MD, PhD, FENS, Fellowship of Indonesian Neurospine Society. And the first one will be given by Dr. Rohadi with Management of Neurotrauma Cases in Natural and Non-Natural Disaster, COVID-19. Time is place is your Dr. Rohadi. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you very much. Good evening, everybody. Thank you for the committee for giving me the chance to share and discuss some knowledge and previous experience. Now, I would like to start my presentation about the my experience in management of the neurotrauma cases in natural and non-natural biological disaster COVID-19. Sorry. Sorry. Stop slide. Next. Agenda layout, I want to give definition, type of disaster, natural disaster, neurotrauma case management in our experience, force non-natural biological disaster, and setting of neurotrauma case management in the COVID-19, and conclusion and take-home message. Disaster is any catastrophic situation in which usual pattern of life or ecosystem are disturbed, and extraordinary emergency measures become necessary to save and preserve human life and the environment. Type of disaster is two types, in natural and man-made disaster. Natural, sorry, for example, meteorological, tsunami, cyclone, topographical earthquake, volcanic landslide, environment global warming, El Nino, biological flood, and now is a epidemic COVID of 19. Human man-made disaster is, for example, technological, industrial, and warfare. Mass casualty management disaster management is the principle is how to management of the victim of mass disaster aim to minimize death and disability. Mass casualty casualty management system, a group consisting of the unit and sector that work together using PICS procedure to minimize the rate of death and disability of victim of mass disaster by using all available resource efficiency. Disaster management system based on one is pre-established procedure using in routine emergency procedure from major incidents, two, maximum use resources, three, multi-sector preparation and response, and four is good coordination all sector including medical team. Field management, the objective disaster victim management is done by preparing to the area of accident or disaster for the management of the victim. Organization, by we must initial assessment, warning message, resource mobilization, and we must save measurement, victim, rescue team, and public. And we must divide the zone of for the safety measure. It's epicentrum is impact zone, and around the impact zone is secondary zone and tertiary zone for the safe measure. Disaster victim management must with the trained staff medical team or voluntary and any team for others with China. And we must search and rescue as soon as possible. And we must triage, medical triage, and evacuation of the triage. With management, first aid is one, for example, stabilization. We must stabilization of ABCD management or functional victim position, control the bleeding, immobilization of the fracture, and dressing or wound care. And from the impact zone, any team, quick team at the working area to evacuate to the collecting point and to the advanced medical force in the on-site, for example, the hospital in on-site. And if we have a hospital in field that depend on resources and facility, we must treat a bit the basic advanced medical force or standard advanced force depend on resources. And a victim refer to the trauma center first is secure and quickly and efficient. And how to establish mass casualty management rescue chain sectoral, we must coordination the every team in the command post, create the patient stabilization, evacuation, and research, rescue, and first aid. And the other team controlling about the regulation and evacuation for the traffic and continue to the hospital. We must management in the free hospital organization and good organization communication with the center of hospital. This is the graphic of the establishing mass casualty management in the area, collecting area. In we found in unstable condition, we must treat area, coloring the taking of the victim, management stabilization, treatment area is a priority, first priority, second priority, and third priority. And when we transport patient after stable condition. And Indonesia is a developing country and many district and many other policy. We must commitment to policy disaster management team organization in the every province in if a disaster incident with the governor had the BPVD task force, a coordination with the head of health department, coordination with the center emergency in trauma center in central hospital, reference center hospital, coordination with region general hospital in area, common center in the area, public health center and auxiliary public health center, and with communication with the emergency team. And team make a common center. This team is a fast moving team for two assessment, triage, communication, medical management the first time. And the other team is can make a disaster crisis center team for early advanced team and late advanced teams. Early advantage, fire, hospital, evacuation, victim identification, medical assistant, and volunteer. And the late advanced team is sanitation, epidemiological surveillance, psychiatrist, advanced treatment, nutritionist, and health counselor in FAR. Neurotrauma case management in disaster, the principle is 50% of fatal case was die on the way to the hospital. And I agree with the other presented about main purpose to prevent to outcome of the traumatic brain injury. We must prevent to hypotension and hypoxia in the field area. Staying at pre-hospital must be minimized after stabilization condition. ABCD management, care, airway, breathing, control, circulation, maintenance, disabilities, very important. Position, a patient unconsciousness, patient lateral position, spinal injury, if we found spinal injury, we must immobilization of the neck with a hard collar neck. All severe traumatic brain injury patient, we must intubation, but in sometime we cannot have any facility, no facility, is recommended back mask ventilation. Resuscitation fluid, isotonic fluid, and sometime we must resuscitation hypotonic is a monitor. If electrical is severe traumatic brain injury. And how about the minimal standard for neurotrauma center in disaster? The principle is we must have neurosurgeon and trauma surgeon on call, formally available all time. Second is 24 hours emergency department with advanced traumatic support and advanced cardiac support China. And we have operating room rapid acceptance all time, CT scan constantly available, MRI ready, and ready to appropriate intensive care unit and high care unit, and sometimes we have buy plus plan. How about natural disaster in Indonesia? In my experience in Lombok area, because Indonesia is ring of fire and risk of the earthquake every years, sometimes every day to the other place in Indonesia. And Lombok, we have experience in 2018 from the until July and August patient, and more than 561 death for the earthquake. Earthquake impact to the, of the natural disaster involve many sector, include the head injury caused by trauma, like multiple trauma contribute to the high rate of mortality, great damage in high population with lack of the infrastructure, poorly building, and this is a mechanism of the trauma in the case. In Lombok Island earthquake in 2018 and started July, more than 160 people are injured and thousands of home are damaged, and more than 19 people have been killed and 100 injured and by earthquake. This is a video condition in this earthquake in Lombok. As many were destroyed in this, and yes, this is a condition. And patient hospital evacuated, attended on the state by doctor, because every medical team applied to the in hospital. And this is a characteristic Lombok earthquake in 2018. As every weeks we every weeks have an earthquake. And the main problem is in reality in our experience is lack of resources compare the amount of the victim and facility. This is a video for our presentation, and every week there was a for major earthquake. This is destroyed in the epicentrum with North Lombok, and this victim and many people are suffering. This is a victim. Our hospital destroyed, but in the Mataram city, many hospital can use to the operating, but many of the team is afraid about the risk of earthquake if we operation in the operating room, and we modification for operating room in the container. This earthquake mapped out. This is a situation in North Lombok, earthquake trias and initial in disaster location. Few hours after earthquake. This is a condition in our hospital in center of traumatic center in West Nusa Tenggara General Province Hospital. And three, we are the three big tent for the patient because massive number of victim, too many patient along the corridor of the hospital, mass casualty of number cases. This is a tent. This earthquake keep repeating every weeks, and we treat the patient in field and in the tent. This condition of operating room after earthquake because many healthcare and medical team afraid about if we operation in the operating room is high risk for the our staff, and we modification container to operation of patient traumatic brain injury. This is a patient characteristic of Lombok earthquake. Totally patient to neurotrauma care is 47 patient, dominant male, child, and dominant scope injury. Dominant direct impact and outcome majority is very good. This is for example extradural hematoma, direct impact and coup injury. This is a depressed fracture, direct impact and coup injury. This is a direct depressed fracture. This is a prolapse cerebri, traumatic intracerebral hemorrhage is usually from the direct impact. This is a traumatic intracerebral and intraventricular hemorrhage in its severity. This patient condition after operation, majority children. Now, how about the non-natural and biological disaster? For our experience, in the COVID-19 is global pandemic. This is a biological disaster. Many countries have suffered from the severe economic consequence of governmental measures to contain the outbreak. Many medical specialist organizations have restricted practice to the essential care services as recommended by the World Health Organization to provide appropriate local response to the outbreak phase in countries and dealing with the wide preventing non-COVID patients and their physicians from infection. How about impact neurosurgery services in our center? Now, in today, COVID-19 cases in West Nusa Tenggara more than 350 cases. That's 7 cases, and our physician. COVID positive is 4 and nurse 1 case. And how about neurosurgery cases care? We only emergency care in the pandemic. Elective surgery are put on hold and traumatic case decreases approximately 70-80%. This is a effect of stay at home. Maybe same in the other other area. How about the prepare in emergency room? All emergency patient with are judged to the high risk factor to the lead the COVID-19 or not. If there is a sufficient mandatory rapid test or swab before decision of taking. How about the prepare in operating room? Duration during the operation, all team that work are those who have already taken rapid test and or swab. And now we know about the Indonesia, all of region Indonesia is red zone. We use PPE level 3 for be safe and protect our body and yourself. This is a condition about triage in our hospital, in emergency room in COVID era. An emergency medicine approach to the COVID-19 shall be focused on identifying and isolating patients at risk for infection, informing hospital infection preventing and local public health authority, and engaging infection disease and other specialists early in care. In no condition is red zone, all patients must be screening for the COVID, checklist COVID, or rapid and or swab. Sometimes we give swab and involve the COVID task force. And all staff of emergency room department, we use PPE level 3, we save and protect yourself. How about the prepare and anesthesia procedure in operating room? All team and the work and all to those who have already had a rapid test and or swab, and we use a level 3 PPE, be safe to protect. And if a patient intubation from the anesthesia, for the general anesthesia, we use a chamber from protect from aerosol. After that, in the neurosurgical operating room, all the patient body covered with plastic, especially in mouth and nose, preventing the aerosol. And we use PPE level 3 for the operation. Some cases in our experience during COVID-19, some patient trauma, for example, is epidural hematoma with traumatic severe brain injury, and from the thorax X-ray shows pneumonia. It's the followed by rapid test or swab, also CT scan. The chest is performed to find a ground glass opacity, and we improve the COVID-19 task force. This, for example, other cases for the during the trauma. This is traumatic brain injury. This for other case in the during COVID-19 prolapse cerebri, pediatric case, and. Conclusion and take home message. Number first, disaster may come anytime and can happen anywhere. Two, we must be prepared to fight disaster. And three, prepare a solid team in all sector, including the medical team. And four, previous experience will make you strong in the fight against disaster. Five, management of disaster must be systematic, and good teamwork is required to give the best result for the patient. And last is, it is important for morale to be kept high. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Hadi, for your time. It's very nice presentation. Dr. Hadi is chairman for Medical Indonesian Association for Mataram Region. I think Dr. Hadi is very busy to keep the natural disaster and non-natural disaster in Mataram region. I think Dr. Dito will give a questionnaire online.
Okay, Dr. thank Dito, you. Please. Okay, thank you, Dr. Teddy. And thank you very much for the great presentation, Dr. Hadi. And now we are back to our second Q session. It's still about the true or false. And I will launch the polling. Okay, there are still two questions. For the first, swab test for COVID-19 is mandatory prior to examination in neurotrauma cases. Is that true or false? And for the second, personal protective equipment, PPE or APD, alat pelindung diri, is mandatory in the management of neurotrauma patient with positive swab test. We have 1 minute to answer.
For Dr. Yuris, Dr. Ahmad Farid, dan Dr. Hanif, mungkin nanti akan kami minta sedikit pendapat untuk mengenai nomor 1 dan nomor 2. Terima kasih. Berapa lama, Dr. Tito, untuk waktu online kuesionernya?
Okay, I think the time is up. And I will show the result of the polling. And here we come. For the number one, swab test for COVID-19 is mandatory prior to examination in neurotrauma. It's all about 54% of voters is answered true. And the second one, personal protective equipment, PPE, is mandatory the management of neurotrauma patient with positive swab test. It's all about 97% voters. That's answer true.
Sebetulnya nomor satu ini sangat ini ya, sangat bersaing ketat ini antara true dan false. Mungkin ini yang kita bahas saja. Mungkin yang pertama dari Dr. Hanif dari Universitas Indonesia. Untuk nomor satu, dokter, apakah swab test pada kasus COVID-19 ini wajib dilakukan pemeriksaan swab pada kasus neurotrauma? Monggo, Dokter Hanif.
Ya, yang dioperasi ini udah pasien dengan COVID atau masih suspek?
Ini kalau dilihat mungkin ini, dok, ya, semua kasus maupun cedera ringan yang konservatif sepertinya, dok. Apakah butuh dilakukan swab?
Kalau masih suspek, saya rasa yeah, perlu dilakukan swab gitu ya, karena kan paparannya, kalau misalnya dia nggak terduga sebagai COVID, itu kan yang berbahaya. Kalau dia udah pasien ya, dengan artinya swabnya positif, ya tentunya nggak perlu lagi ya, dan kita udah prepare dengan APD level 3. Yang bahayanya itu pasien ini nggak ketahuan gitu COVID. Itu yang menurut saya ya gimana itu, apakah perlu di swab apa enggak gitu. Makanya kalau tergantung pertanyaannya nih, pasien ini udah definitively COVID apa belum? Kalau dia definitive COVID aman, kalau dia belum, nah ini perlu swab saya rasa ya, karena APD-nya itu kan belum tentu level 3 kalau misalnya dengan pasien-pasien yang belum positif COVID. Itu pendapat saya sih, terima kasih ya.
Baik, terima kasih Dr. Hanif untuk pendapatnya. Mungkin yang kedua, Dr. Yuris dari Semarang. Silakan Dr. Yuris. Untuk nomor satu, Dr. Yuris. Karena ya, bersaing ketat true dan false nih.
Ya, Assalamualaikum.
Salam.
Ya, memang sangat-sangat ini ya, apa namanya, menurut saya memang swab test ini, swab COVID ini sangat-sangat perlu dilakukan, terutama pasien-pasien yang memang membutuhkan perawatan cukup lama di rumah sakit. Karena memang, tetapi untuk kasus-kasus neurotrauma yang membutuhkan pembedahan, selama kita menggunakan APD atau PPE level 3, saya pikir insya Allah lah, mungkin kita tidak perlu terlalu menunggu swab test, karena respon time itu yang dibutuhkan untuk kasus-kasus neurotrauma yang membutuhkan emergency case. Cuman untuk pasien yang tidak membutuhkan emergency case, saya pikir mandatory ya. Karena memang kita juga sulit gitu, kita akan mengecek apakah ada kontak atau tidak, itu kan kita kesulitan. Ya, salah satunya cara untuk membuat kita safe sendiri adalah ya swab test, itu saya pikir membutuhkan banget. Apalagi dengan kecurigaan kalau itu memang pasien, kecurigaan pasien gitu ya, dengan kecurigaan adanya ground glass di foto torak dan lain-lain. Nah, seperti itu.
Ya, betul baik, lagi. Jadi, kemudian dari Dr. Farid dari Bandung, mungkin ada masukan untuk kuesioner nomor 1, Dr. Farid, karena sangat bersaing ketat ini, true dan false-nya 54% banding 46%.
Iya, terima kasih. Ya. Jadi kalau mau ngomong ideal ya, memang harusnya swab. Karena dalam pelaksanaannya kita nggak pernah tahu datanya. Walaupun nanti hasilnya agak lebih lama, ya, tetapi kita tetap harus punya data karena selanjutnya pasien-pasien dengan neurotrauma itu kan nanti dilihat dari severity-nya, dia masuk ke ICU kah atau dia masuk ruangan kah gitu. Sementara orang di ruangan tetap harus tahu gitu statusnya karena untuk keselamatan kita bersama. Tapi kalau swabnya nggak ada, tetap saja saya rasa sih level di bawahnya harus dikerjakan ya untuk rapidnya. Karena kalau tidak ada data itu, saya rasa akan sulit. Tapi ini ideal ya, dalam pelaksanaannya tidak semua. Mungkin itu yang false-nya karena kita berdiri di atas kenyataan gitu ya. Karena tidak mungkin ya, jadi tidak harus gitu. Tapi kalau secara ideal memang harusnya semua dilakukan. Karena tanpa itu kita membahayakan rekan-rekan kita, terutama di center-center pendidikan ya, yang ya mungkin residen akan menjadi garis terdepan. Ini memang harus diproteksi. Jadi sebaiknya sih dilakukan.
Baik, terima kasih Dr. Farid. Nah, pada intinya kita semua sebagai tenaga kesehatan harus berhati-hati. Kita semua harus menguasai gejala klinis maupun jawaban dari laboratoris dari pasien-pasien COVID. Selayaknya kita mengetahui bagaimana gejala klinis dan bagaimana gambaran laboratorium dari masing-masing pasien COVID. Dengan itu, insya Allah kita semua akan bisa mengetahui dan bisa stay safe dari pasien COVID.